Hi, my name's Archie O'Connor and I'm outside Parliament with Fathers for Justice to help every child to see their father.
I'm here tonight with my son, Archie O'Connor, who's in fact nearly taller than me now. Obviously I'm the founder of, my name's Matt O'Connor, the founder of Fathers for Justice, my son Archie. And we're outside Parliament because we've got a meeting tonight with the Child Maintenance Service Focus Group talking about the issues surrounding the dysfunctional and disgraceful Child Maintenance Service, formerly known as the Child Support Agency. And obviously, we are campaigning for fundamental, radical reform of this system. We want to give children like Archie, the benefit of the love and care of both his parents, the love and support of both his parents, emotionally and financially. And that's what child support should mean. Child support should mean emotional and financial support. It shouldn't mean that fathers are reduced to cash points, are reduced to pounds, shillings and pence. It means that both parents have a fundamental and equal role raising their children. So we've got a focus group tonight. Archie's very kindly come along to help us. Appreciate it, even though you're my son. But it's important that the views and records of ordinary dads are placed on the record with the Child Maintenance Service and the government. So that's what we hope to achieve tonight, yeah?
Yeah.
Ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's do it, come on.
The one thing I would change is that it should be 50-50 to start with, and you should go for some kind of mediation where the mother can put her side across, the father can put his side across. Then you come to an agreement that's fair, rather than straight away the mother takes the child, leaves you with all the bills for house, etc., then phones up child maintenance and demands the maintenance payments, and then you have to fight to have one night or two nights or three nights a week for your child, and the mother still gets all the money.
I would say more mutually driven process. So at the moment, the decisions that get made, the mother calls up, says he's got two jobs, for example. No evidence to back it up. I'm the one who has to evidence that after the calculation has been made. But the child maintenance that aren't accountable or don't hold themselves accountable for process incorrectly. It should be a mutually driven system where if a mother puts something forwards, they should speak to the father to determine before any calculation is made. That it's a mutually driven process.
One biggest thing I would change is the fact that if the mother doesn't claim or make any claims a year, she can still phone up and backdate the whole claim and you're just left with a bill that you've cough up with and come up with, which is totally wrong.
And do you see your children or?
No, it's been 3.5 years. Harriet and Cooper, if you ever see this, I love you, and Dad.
Oh, bless you, brother. Bless you, brother.
Corruption, everything, and I've done nothing wrong. And unless I've got any more money now, I won't ever see my children. It's disgusting. It really is disgusting.
I think the meeting went well. It's just the same. Every non-resident parent is in like the same situation. The main thing I would like to change is it starts at 50-50, shouldn't it? They need to swap over. The less time you see the kid, the more you pay. I'd be more happy to pay more to see my child more. So if they swapped it over, I'd be so much happier. More willing to pay, but it's all in the women's favour. No, it just needs to change.
And do you see your kids or?
I don't, I've not seen my daughter for 7 months now.
7 months, right, okay.
So it's £400 a month and it just adds up, but you don't get to see your child.
No.
There's no justice. No.
There's a lot of passion in the room, for sure. If we could harness all of that energy, it would be fantastic. I hope they listen. I think it was really constructive. And what would I change about child maintenance? It provides an incentive for breaking families down. It provides an incentive for child abuse. It's created an industry that doesn't actually need to be there, and we're the whipping boys for it. And it's completely counterintuitive to everybody's health. Even those that are perpetuating getting some money out of it, you know, at what cost to the children that they're going to pay a big price for in years to come. So.
I think the meeting went really well. There were a lot of really good points raised. I think that a lot of changes need to be made. I think that because people are paying maintenance regarding how many nights the children are staying, I think that's having a very negative effect on family courts, and the resident parent is then taking the child away from the non-resident parent,
yeah.
And that's causing a lot of issues regarding the CMS.
I would make it immediate presumption of 50-50 sharing. I know it's sort of 98% mothers get custody, but you need to change that immediately. And then I think when you start off with that, you will stop the absolute hatred of the system being changed to having matrimonial disputes. So yeah, I think that if you started at 50-50 sharing, you would get rid of about 70% of the problems overnight.